Welcome to the antibiotic susceptibility video. This video is in place of actually completing the lab in case we're not able to. In this video, I'm going to talk about the Kirby-Bauer method for determining antibiotic susceptibility. Kirby-Bauer method is pretty simple to do. It's actually very similar to the setup for lab 7.1 when we did the chemical sensitivity lab. First, you're going to create a lawn of bacteria on a Mueller-Hinton auger plate. So the bacteria spread around with the little hockey stick and the pottery wheels that we use. If the organism, or the after that, you place little antibiotic discs on the plate. So these are preloaded with the antibiotic, and the antibiotic diffuses into the media. And depending on the molecular structure and chemical structure and weight of that antibiotic, it will diffuse at different rates, different distances in the media. And if the organism is killed or inhibited by the concentration of that antibiotic, there'll be an area of no growth around that immediate area. So that we call that the zone of inhibition. So after you create the lawn, you place these little antibiotics right on the disc or on the plate. And like I mentioned, that antibiotic is going to diffuse through. So here we have an image showing a bunch of antibiotics that are showing zones of inhibition, whereas this one, label P, has very little zone of inhibition. So you might assume that all of these antibiotics work except P, but in order to actually do so, you have to use what we call the zone of inhibition table in pages 434, 435 in the textbook. So while looking at that, table in the book, if the diameter in millimeters is equal to or less than the number in the resistance column for that antibiotic, then the organism is resistant to the antibiotic. If the diameter is equal to or greater than the number in the sensitive column for the antibiotic, then the organism is sensitive to the antibiotic. So let's try it. So let's assume this organism, and you can see the bacteria growing on the plate. Assume this is Staph aureus, and A here, we measure a zone of 20 millimeters. What is the result? Here's the actual chart, screenshot of the table, and here you see many people also confuse this, and they say, well, if it's ampicillin, they're looking here on page 434, and they're going to say, well, that 20 millimeters is less than, or sorry, greater than 17, and they'll say it's sensitive. However, Staph aureus is gram-positive. So here, gram-positive, here, this is for gram-negative. So we actually have to use this ampicillin section here for on page 435. So the answer is resistant. So 20 millimeters is less than 28 millimeters. All right, so let's try that again. Bacitracin, 14 millimeters, and ciprofloxacin, 22 millimeters. So take a moment, pause the video, and see what you get. And I didn't add a C, but we can use this one as a C. It doesn't really matter. Let's just pretend. All right, so in both cases, the answer is sensitive. Both would work. Now, here's a question that I always like to ask. Ciprofloxacin works better than bacitracin. Is that true or false? So most people think true. 22 millimeters is greater than 14 millimeters. However, this answer to this is false. Just because the zone of inhibition is larger than another, it doesn't necessarily mean that it works better. Okay, so we don't compare apples to apples here. In both cases, both of these antibiotics will work. So we don't rank them based on the size of the zone. Okay, both work. Bacitracin is actually a topical antibiotic. Ciprofloxacin, this can be an oral, you know, application. So don't rank based off the size of the zone. Both of these work. That's what we would be determining. They either work or they don't. So I hope this helps explain the Kirby-Bauer method. Unfortunately, we weren't able to actually do this lab, but hopefully this helps explain that lab.